Good morning. We're here again to hear what God's saying to us through this short devotional. Have you ever been stuck in the mud? I grew up in a place where there were initially no tarred roads. One of the dirt roads to our house went through a flay, and frequently people got stuck in the mud on that road. Cars often got stuck there, and my dad had a 1939 Chev, and he was often called to pull cars out of the mud, so much so that he made a special steel cable tow rope so that he could do it from a distance, a longer tow rope, so that he could stand on firm road to pull the cars out. And he also had wheel chains, which I still have in my garage, and I've used them on many occasions when I lived in the bush. For those who don't know, wheel chains fit over the car's tires and give it amazing traction in mud and snow or ice. And they're in my garage, they're not going to be used. But I thought there may be a collector somewhere who would like to have them, and I offered them for sale. Nobody is even interested in those wheel chains. Today, the driver doesn't get out in the mud and fit the chains. He sits in the vehicle and flips a switch to lock up the transmission in an off-road or soft road 4x4 or an all-wheel drive configuration, and it's so much easier. But it's not always foolproof. Some all-wheel drives are for soft roads, others for off-roads, and others are just there for better road holding, particularly in the icy conditions found in North America and Europe. But wheel chains? No. Listen to Hebrews chapter 1, and I'm going to just read those beautiful words in the first four verses. In the past, God spoke to our ancestors through the prophets at many times and in various ways. But in these last days, he has spoken to us by his Son, whom he appointed heir of all things, and through whom he also made the universe. The Son is the radiance of God's glory and the exact representation of his being, sustaining all things by his powerful word. And after he had provided purifications for sins, he sat down at the right hand of the majesty in heaven, and so became as much superior to the angels as the name he has inherited is superior to theirs. Those verses tell us that in the past, God spoke. God spoke. And he spoke through the prophets. Through Moses, he gave us the law. But now he has spoken through his Son. Look at that verse 3. That verse 3 says to us, the Son is the radiance of God's glory and the exact representation of his being, sustaining all things by his powerful word. And after he, that is Jesus, after Jesus had provided purification for sins, he sat down at the right hand of the majesty in heaven. He made a new way. He made a better way for the purification of our sins. The theme of Hebrews is a better way. This is what God gave us through the prophets. This is what God gave us through the patriarchs, our forefathers. And this is what God gives us through Jesus, a better way. You don't have to get out of the car in the mud and spin the wheels to feed the wheel chains underneath the wheel so that they can be tightened. We don't have to slaughter an animal or be in bondage to the law for forgiveness of sin. And so we sit in the car, we have diff locks, we have all-wheel drive, we had sensors, microprocessors in the wheel so that the wheel that is spinning doesn't get powered, goes to the others. All sorts of things, a better way of getting through the mud. And Hebrews says, here is a better way. But now, Jesus has appeared once for all to do away with sin by the sacrifice of himself. Isn't that wonderful? We don't have to sacrifice animals. Jesus has become that sacrifice, the Lamb of God who takes away the sin of the world, a better way. And you know, Jesus lifts us out of the miry clay into which we have fallen. And by his blood and the sacrifice that he has made, he cleanses us, he forgives us, and he sets our feet on firm ground in a new way. And I say, thank you, Jesus. Let us pray. Lord Jesus, there was a day in my life when you came and you made yourself known to me as my Savior. When you took me, I wasn't a bad guy. But all of us have sin. The Word of God says so. And I was a sinner. And that day I was saved by grace. And we thank you that you have a better way of salvation for all of us. That is salvation by faith, it is salvation by grace. It is salvation by your intervention into the history of men and women. And we come today, Lord, and we give you thanks. And oh Lord, give us that deep assurance that we have eternal life in you. That when this life comes to an end, there's even a better way to be with you in glory, that we will be changed in the blinking of an eye. And we will see you and we will be like you. And we look to that day with joyful anticipation. Even so, come Lord Jesus. Amen. Go well, walk with him, and trust him in all things.
On a hill far away stood an old rugged cross, the emblem of suffering and shame. How I love that old cross, where the dearest and best for a world of lost sinners was slain. I'll cherish the old rugged cross till my trophies at last I lay down. I will cling to the old rugged cross and exchange it someday crown. Oh, that old rugged cross, so despised by the world, has a wondrous attraction for me. For the dear Lamb of God left his glory above, bear it to dark Calvary. So I'll cherish the old rugged cross till my trophies at last I lay down. I will his glory forever I'll share.
someday for a crown. I will cling to the old rugged cross and exchange it someday.